Hi guys, nice to be with you all again today. We're following the daily Bible readings, the Bible in 1 year, and today it's the first part of Romans chapter 4. We heard yesterday that Paul had taught that all have sinned and fall short of God's glory, and that the way back to God comes from God himself. It comes through the gift and sacrifice of his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Today, Paul takes his hearers to the story of Abraham. Abraham lived a long time before Moses and before the Ten Commandments and God's laws were given. And the questions asked, how was Abraham put right with God? Was he put right with God through keeping the commandments? Obviously not, because he lived a long time before the commandments. Well then, was Abraham special in any way? Was he a good man? Is that how he became right with God? And the answer to that, of course, is no. Abraham was just an ordinary man, like you and me. He was a sinner. He was from a family of idol worshippers. But how was Abraham put right with God? The Bible says he believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness. That's like he had a bank account with nothing in it, and God credited that account. Abraham had no righteousness of his own, but God credited righteousness to him the moment he believed and had faith in God. God called Abraham to leave his country and his family and to go to a new land that God was going to give him. Abraham went, not knowing where he was going, but trusting in God's promise that through him all the nations of the earth would be blessed. And so Abraham had faith in God, and he was declared to be righteous on that basis. It was all to do with God, not to do with Abraham, not because Abraham was a good guy, but just because Abraham believed in God's plan and went along with it. And that's how you and I are to be put right with God today. We are to trust in God's plan and go along with it. What's God's plan for us today? His plan comes through his Son, Jesus. Jesus died for you and me on the cross. He was there as a sacrifice for our sins. You see, it was far too big for us to handle. Getting right with God was impossible for you and for me. We needed God to do it, and God has done it. It's like if you've been given a big job to do and it's just totally impossible for you to do it, but somebody bigger and stronger comes in and does the job for you. That's what Jesus has done. It was all too much for us. We could never do it. We could never put ourselves right with God. But Jesus has done it for us when he paid the price for our sins on the cross and rose again. And now Jesus can enter our lives by his Holy Spirit. David also spoke of the happiness of the man whose sin God doesn't hold against him. David also had faith in God and knew his sins to be forgiven. That's how we're saved today. That's how we're forgiven today. By faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. By believing that on that cross he died for you. Realizing that your only hope of getting right with God is Jesus. Jesus is the only Savior. His name is the only name under heaven given to people by which we must be saved. There's no other Saviour. There's no other plan. Only Jesus. That's why we emphasise every day the lovely Lord Jesus, the one who came from heaven, the one who is God himself, the one who gave his life on the cross for us. But you say, wasn't Abraham religious? Didn't he get circumcised? Yes, he did. But Abraham was circumcised because God told him to do it. And he was circumcised after God made him right with himself. And you see, it's not by religion. It's not by anything that we can do. It's all of God. And it's all of Jesus. Believe in the Lord Jesus today, and you will be saved. You will be made up, justified, made right with God, made 100%, credited in your account the righteousness of Jesus. And God looks at me just as if I'd never sinned. And what I have, you can have today. You need Jesus. Trust in him. Trixie and I love you all very, very much. Thank you for watching. God bless you.
See his love nailed onto a cross, perfect and blameless life, given a sacrifice. Such a love.